Hey, welcome to another video on this channel. And someone asked about a tutorial and someone asked about the Neurofunk bass tutorial. So I'm trying to create some kind of Neurofunk bass in this tutorial. So, and we start, of course, with the polygrid, and I'm turning on my keyboard here so that I can use it. Turn on my headphones and we can start. And the first thing I'm going to do is to exchange this envelope here for an ADSR to have more control. And exchange the triangle to a phase one because I like this phase one oscillator. And then cloning this one. So I have two. And I'm phase modulating the one oscillator with the other. And you can see you get a nice sounding bass pretty fast, and it's all about what you are aiming for and what sound you are going for. And there are probably a thousand of ways to do this. And this is pretty much the easiest and fastest way. You just need two phase oscillators here and a bit distortion. And the right amount of values on the knobs, of course. So this is one easy setup for a bassline, and maybe we can add some fancy FX, maybe add one of these all-pass filters here, put only on upper frequencies, high pass, there it is, and one of these mixer devices. Or modules. Maybe try and add some filters. And maybe also again distortion. Or wave. that's maybe a bit too much. Go to C5. When this knob is at 100% here, the filter actually changes when you press different keys. So the filter is basically moving when you press different keys. Okay. So let's add some EQ in the FX stage here. And maybe add a macro knob here, because we can define now a range for the EQ setting. And we can use this macro knob here later on in the automation process, or in the when we create a track, we can then draw in some automation. And we can also define not only the EQ here, we can also define some other different parameters here in the grid itself. And the whole secret about having these neurofunk baseline, or creating these neurofunk baselines, is basically the movement of different parameters in the right ranges, on the right sweet spot areas. So maybe also at one of these FX2 devices here, to actually only apply the blur device on the upper frequencies. And try maybe a very short reverb to get this metallic feel. So this is good enough for me, for this tutorial at least, to show you how you can create such neurofunk bass lines pretty fast and easy. And maybe draw on some notes here. And yeah. Let's take the perfect fifth here. Let's take this one just for the demo. When you are finished with creating the clips, the MIDI clips or the note clips for the bass line here, then you start to bounce down everything to audio. That's what I do usually to create more edits and small changes like reversing certain audio files or apply filtering, pitch shifting and so on, and draw in all the automation here at the bottom. It's all about keep the sound interesting. You can always go back to your original patch here, make some small changes to create a different kind of sound for bridges or breaks or so on. And yeah, it's all about the changes, small changes, small edits, and keep the sound interesting. This patch is now called Neuropunk, and I put this patch into my GitHub repository, and there's also a link down in the description. And that's it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.